In fact, General Katawal is also in Delhi to attend a Track 2 conference just a week ahead of the withdrawal of the United Nations mission in Nepal that had been monitoring the truce. The mission leaves without a formal settlement on the issue of integration of ex-Maoist combatants with the Nepalese army. Some analysts argue that India's concerns over Nepal coincide with this exit. Nitin Gokhale spoke exclusively to the ex-army chief about how Nepal's fragile peace hinges on the crucial issue of the army's future.
Why is the democracy very fragile in Nepal? What is the problem?
Well, right now, our political masters have not been able to sit down together, put their heads together. I was just requesting my political leaders in a session that any national army looks at issues from national angle, from national perspective, with national vision. So I requested them that they should rise above the regionalism, the ethnicity and religion, and then talk about one Nepal first, because we need a country called Nepal, united, integrated and indivisible, a sovereign in the modern sense, and Nepal has to remain an independent country between two rival but rising powers. And it can do it only when there's a national consensus.
You think Nepal has become, you just mentioned this, that Nepal has to be independent from the two competing rivals. Do you think Nepal has become a playground for competing self-interest of India and China?
Well, any country would have the interest, the national interest, the security interest, the economic interest, you know, in today's world, because we've become so interdependent. We're talking about globalization, one village and all those kind of things. So naturally, India has its own interest, China has its own interest, and Nepal does have its own interest. And Nepal should be able to convince both neighbors that Nepal is not in a position, neither it would like to play one neighbor against the other. Rather, it would like to act as a transit point, taking advantage, looking at between these large, vast countries. Nepal is a tiny, weeny, little country. Nothing much, given the size of population, the size of the land mass of these two neighbors.
But tell me something. I mean, the Maoists also seem to have a problem with India and pro-India elements in Nepal's political spectrum. What is your view on that? Are they targeting India specifically at somebody's behest, at China's behest, let's say?
Well, what I can tell you is, in today's world, Nitin, you just cannot declare a neighbor as your principal enemy. Is it viable? It is practical. Can Nepal survive declaring India or China a principal enemy? This is where, there's a differences with the people, with the political parties and all. And you know it all. If things happen in their favor, everything is all right. If things do not happen in their favor, and then it is against Nepal, against Nepalese. I mean, the people of Nepal, I don't think they would accept this.
What role can the Nepalese army play? Because you actually had a long career and a very distinguished career in Nepalese army. What role can the Nepalese army play in the current fragile situation in Nepal?
Nepalese army would never ever challenge the mandate of the people, the civilian supremacy, like in any other democracy. But then when you say that, it is always the last burden falls on the army,